I tell you what, guys, this is not an easy road to travel on. In fact, it's very hard. It's incredibly hard because it is a spiritual battle, and every day is a test. And every day we have to fight off the demons that surround us. But you know what makes it worth it? Is when we get those blessings. When we spread the message that we need to spread, to make it known that King Yahushua is coming back. You better believe he's coming back. You better believe that this is a spiritual battle. We have not started the war, but we will. And it's coming soon. And if you don't have your armor on, then you will not be prepared. And you will fall short. And you will submit. I'm sorry to tell you that. My husband came to me and said that we were just blessed and we have enough for 2 nights at a hotel. The previous message that I was recording that I'm going to upload now, I feel it was a message that I needed to say and to put out there, because we need to hear this. Everyone needs to hear this, whether you take it in or you don't take it in. You need to hear it. Judging others is not okay. It's demonic. We don't need to judge. We don't know the situation. You don't know the situation. You can't just go and get a job. It's not that easy. It's not that easy to just go and get a job. Oh yeah, go get a job. They'll hire you. After my husband, for example, has been putting out his resume and applying at different places, and no one's been accepting. And even if they did accept, it's gonna take a while before they even actually say, hey, yeah, you got a job. And even after that, you have 2 weeks that you have to wait for the paycheck to come in. Meanwhile, you still need a roof over your head. Meanwhile, you still need to be able to take a shower. You still need to be able to feed yourself. And it's all part of the beast system, guys. I mean, we're going to have lockdowns pretty soon, and winter is coming, and you think this is over? You got another thing coming. It's just a distraction if you think elections are going to do anything. Remember one thing. Remember this. Okay? If you take anything away, these people up top are not elected. Okay? Who cares about the election fraud? It's a distraction. They're not elected. They're selected. Let me say that again. They are selected. Meaning they work for Hasatan, for Satan, up top. He selects the people that are doing his bidding. He selects the people that are going to do his bidding, his dirty work. And you know what's going to end up happening at the end? He doesn't give a rat's ass about any of them. And that is the truth. If there's anyone that you need to follow Yahushua. Yahushua walked in righteousness, and he taught the law in righteousness. That's who you need to follow. It's not an easy walk. Only those that are deserving. And I'm not saying that I'm deserving. I'm definitely not saying I'm deserving, because sometimes I feel I'm not deserving at all. But that is not my judgment to make. I could be the most difficult, judgmental person judging myself, because I am not perfect. Perfection is not in my vocabulary. It's more like mediocre or less. But it is not up to me to judge myself. It is up to Abba Yahuwah. He is the judge of all things, of all creation. And you know who's going to defend me? Even with my sins, even with my mistakes, even with everything that I've done in my entire life, you know who's going to defend me? Who's going to be right there on the day of judgment, defending me to his Father? It's going to be my King, King Yahushua, my HaMashiach, my Savior. He's going to be the one defending me for all the right things that I did, even though I made mistakes. And I have been doing my utmost thus to repent from the mistakes that I've made. I'm sure I've missed a lot. But he's going to be the one defending me. And if you don't have his back, if you don't believe in him, well, I don't know what to tell you. I do not know what to tell you. He's going to be the one defending me. He's going to be the one defending those that follow him, those that have the ability to follow him, the willingness to follow him, the will to follow him, the momentum to follow him, and to live by his word, by his teaching, and to spread his word and his teaching. I'm not a teacher. I went to school to be a teacher, but I'm not a teacher. I'm just relating whatever I learned from scripture, and I'm just relating it to you guys. That's all I'm doing. That's my job. And living through this experience of being homeless is one that I can use to reflect on my own life and my own lessons and my own trials in a way to give you reasons why you should always put Abba Yahuwah first and always have trust in him. Always. Always. I don't know how many times, and I've said it in so many of my videos. You go back on my YouTube videos. There's been so many times where I've been so scared out of my mind that I was going to lose my job of all things. My goodness. How are you going to make ends meet? I put my faith and I put my trust, even as small as a mustard seed at that time, as small as a mustard seed. I just took a deep breath and trusted in him, and he pulled through, and he has yet to let me down. Let me just tell you that. He has yet to let me down. And things may not work according to what I think they should do or should be, but that's not how our Heavenly Father works. That's not how it works. Friends, if we are to walk as Yahushua did when he was here on earth, then we have to do as he did. He gave up everything and allowed Abba Yahuwah to control everything. Anything that he did, it was the doing of Abba Yahuwah. He was the one leading the way for King Yahushua. He was the one telling him what to do. He was the one allowing things to happen, all the miracles that people experienced. It was because of Abba Yahuwah and because King Yahushua gave it to Abba Yahuwah. This is who we must learn through example. Enough of trying to control everything. Enough of that. Without Abba Yahuwah, we are nothing. We are nothing. Think about it. How many times have you tried to do things on your own and not prayed about it? When you pray, you are giving it to Abba Yahuwah. You are asking with your heart. And when it doesn't work out, well, then that's on you. That's your doing. I'll just... If you're going to go on this walk, you have to understand that you have to give it all up and you have to give it all to Abba Yahuwah. And you have to give all control to Him. He's the one leading the way. He's the one leading the way. King Yahushua is taking orders from Abba Yahuwah. King Yahushua will go ahead of you and make a way, but ultimately it's Abba Yahuwah who's leading the way. He's the one in control of everything. He controls the people around you. He allows their heart to be hardened. He allows their heart to be softened, to come to the truth and understanding. He opened up the truth to me. I could have known the truth a long time ago because I've been wanting to learn, but never really understood until I prayed about it. And then He opened my eyes. This is a spiritual battle, and if you are willing and to do His work and to spread His word, you will receive blessings. You're going to go through trials, but you have to learn from those trials. I'm here recording the trials that I've been going through. It's definitely not easy. All these things, all these experiences, I'm telling you right now before it starts happening, the spiritual realm is opening up, and it's opening up and it's showing itself, and eventually it is going to be revealed to everything, to everyone, and it's not going to be hidden anymore. And people are going to wonder what happened. What happened to the peaceful? This is so-called peace right now. We're just blinded. They're just a covering right now. So I pray, if you are willing and you want to learn the truth, you pray about it. Ask Abba Yahuwah. If you really mean it in your heart and in your soul, He will reveal it to you. With that, I'm going to say goodbye.